Good job. Never gonna run dry. Never gonna come up empty. Now until the day I die, unconditionally. You know I'm always gonna be here for you. No one's ever gonna love you more than God, your mama, and me. God, your mama, and me. Unconditionally.
Hello, good morning, everybody, and welcome to our weekend vlog. We have lots of things to get done today. So first we need to go to my grandmother's. Where's the lighting? Come on, lighting, let's go. We need to go to my grandmother's, clean her house. We need to do groceries at some point. I'm doing my friend's.
Mom, please fit this up.
Okay, hang on. So I need to do my friend's hair today because her parents have like a renewal of their vows. So I'm gonna do that. And I'm nervous because I don't want to mess up. And then after that, I need to clean my house. I want to wash my blinds because I don't know if you guys like look at your blinds, but blinds like hold a lot of dust. And I swear I just did mine like a couple months ago and they're full of dust again. So that is what the plan is for today. So right now, before we go, I'm trying to set up the Bluetooth for my phone and my car because I got a new car. Select a device, add, waiting, please search for the name below using your Bluetooth. Let's go. I got a new car because they were leasing this car, which is a lease, by the way. My car wasn't even old. There was nothing wrong with my car. It was perfect. I loved that car. If you didn't know what it was, I had a Chevy Traverse. It was like a 2014. And I traded it in for this lease because if you guys don't know, my husband works at a Toyota dealer. So obviously we get good deals and we just want to be in Toyotas because he works there. So, and he'll know what to do if he needs to work on it. So we ended up just getting into this lease and it's a 2018 Toyota Highlander. It's got the captain seats and all the black leather, which I didn't have in my Traverse, and I didn't have the sunroof. And I really love having my sunroof back, and I love the leather heated seats. And I love, my favorite part is the captain seats because, I'll show you guys. The captain seats are basically just one big seat and then another big seat, and then you have the back third row. I think it just kind of splits up the girls a little bit better, and you guys know that we want to have another baby, so in the future it'll just be nice to have Brielle and the baby or whoever in the back, and they won't be so crammed like we were in the bucket seats. Like we were in the bench seats. But the only downfall about the captain seats is that we lose the middle seat. So Brielle's kind of adjusting to being behind me because she does get car sick if we go for long distance. So that's the only thing that I'm a little worried about, but that's okay. We will figure it out. All right, we gotta go. Brielle is freaking out. All right, let's buckle up and head out, okay? Got my groceries done, my grandmother's house cleaned, it's coming, and my friend's hair done. I'm going to make Brielle lunch, which is cooking right there in the microwave, and then I'm going to try and clean my blinds like I had said this morning. I really don't want to clean them, but I feel like, oh, sorry guys. But I feel like as a homeowner, I need to keep things clean.
Mom,
oh, God. and I thought my house was clean. What the heck? All right, so I'm a little proud of myself. Came out really good. Better than I thought and much easier. Because then I would have had to put them in the tub. So Becky, if you're watching this, thanks for the idea. I hear you. Thanks for the idea. It looks much better and not as furry as my other one. Paw Patrol mac and cheese for my baby. It's really hot. Mommy put some ice cubes in it. So mix it around. See? Put the... There you go. Is it good?
Let me eat it.
Yeah, it's Paw Patrol mac and cheese. Those are their little paws. Aren't they cute?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't eat them. They're very hot.
It is very hot. No, don't eat it right now. It's very hot.
No, it's not very hot. I just touched it and it's not boiling me.
Oh, it's not? No. Oh, all right.
It's not. It's cooling down.
Oh, it's cooling down. Good. We're heading to camp for a little bit until Tyler gets home from work because we are hot. We want to swim, right, Bri Bri? Yeah, cool down at camp. And we brought the dogs with us too. So we're gonna head up to camp and go swimming. Yeah. You excited, honey? What? Mimi said, yeah, it could be warm. We don't know. We'll see. Because we had rain the other night. All right, see you when we get there. It's good today. Show me how you swim. Oh, Wensie's like, I'll show you how I swim, Mom. I'm having a little issue right now with my drink. Usually Tyler's here with me to help me open it, and he's not here. So, I don't know how I'm gonna do this. Bri-Bri, where are you going in the weeds? I'm trying my hardest to do this. Come on, where's Tyler when you need him? Get this off! Ow! Oh my god! This is the worst thing ever. I did it! I did it! It's warm now, but still good. See, Tyler, I can do it. Just takes me like a half hour. All right, am I getting on first or you? Okay, get on. Get up there, sloppy boppy. What are you doing? You hanging out? Bye. Say bye.
Bye.
So it is now like 3:30 in the afternoon. I'm home, Tyler's home, and we are about to set up our, well, halfly set up our new pool. So we purchased this for the girls and for my daycare because it's really hard in the daytime to like get wet inside of a really small pool. So we figured that this would be a good way to get all of us wet and the kids and then, you know, We can still go up to camp on the weekends and weeknights, but this will get us through the daytime. But we're having kind of an issue because our yard is all slopes. There's no flat area. So we set up the pool last week and it was tilting. It was like all leaning to one side. And then our water, like in our well, we ran out of water. So it was like rusty brown. So we dumped it all out. We got one of those big water gallon tank things and we're gonna start filling it at camp and then dumping it into the pond, into the pool. So that is the plan. So today, the plan right now is to just level out the land. Oh Jesus, here comes the razor. So the plan is to level out the land and get it flat. And then tomorrow we'll start filling it up with water.
So we got a good start. It looks pretty level, but there's some spots that we have a question about. So once we start putting the water in a little bit, and we'll see where the water starts flowing, and hopefully that'll help solve our issues.
So our plan is tomorrow morning we're gonna wake up around like 8 and
no, like 7, cause it takes this thing back 2 hours to do makeup and
I'm not doing my makeup tomorrow, and we kind of figured out that we're gonna need to go back and forth to the pond about like 10 times. So, good thing it's close, right?
Yeah, we have a long day.
Let's go cook some dinner. Good morning, everybody. It is Sunday and it is 11 o'clock. I'm pretty sure it's 11, yeah. Because my belly is hungry, so that means it's close to lunch. So, a little update on the pool today. We got everything leveled yesterday and it came out really, really good. And today we got our pump. So we've been pumping water out of the river and it's going good so far. So this is what we have so far. It's looking a little brown, but we're going to shock it tonight and it will take care of it and filter it and everything. So it's looking a lot better than it was. We're not having an issue on the sides anymore and everything's looking pretty good. The water's not pushing anywhere and this is where we kind of leveled it. So it looks a lot better. It's coming along very well. Tyler just went to go get another load of water because we're probably gonna need to make at least 10 trips before this pool is actually filled up. So while he's gone getting more water, I'm gonna go make us some sandwiches for lunch. And then hopefully by tonight, the pool will be done, which I'm sure it will be. And we'll shock it and then this week we'll be able to swim in it. So that is what is going on our Sunday today. Brielle, do you like the pool?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun, huh? Are you swimming naked or in a bathing suit?
In a bathing suit.
No, you're naked. So it is now 6 hours later and our pool is on its last round of water. One more thing of water and it should be filled up. We're almost to the red line that's on the pool. And it's been a long day, but we had an issue with the water pulling to one side and then we would fix that and then it would go to another. So we finally have it all done. Basically all the way around we had to fill with dirt, but for the most part, it's really, really good. I went in and I was pushing on the sides all the way around to make sure that it wasn't gonna push out, and it's looking awesome. It's doing its job. Brielle is already in, she's naked, and she really doesn't even care that it's still brown. We are about to, well, we're not about to, we're gonna do our last load of water and then we're going to shock it so that way it balances the pH in the water, which in turn will take out the brown in the water. And then we'll sift out the rest of like the leaves that came in from the river and all that. So we are on the home stretch and I'm so excited. The water is super warm already. We pulled it from the river, so it's like basically warm. And hopefully by tonight the pool will be clear, or at least by tomorrow I'm thinking it'll probably be clear, but it doesn't really hurt us. We'll swim in it regardless, but we do need to do it soon because algae starts to grow in this type of stuff. So definitely excited. Look at you swimming. Whoa, swimmy, swimmy, swimmy.